Hello, this is Hervé from the Brahms team, and today we will start a series of video together with my colleague Stijn Calders. We will propose you a series of short videos to give you more information in a more funny way, hopefully, and interactive way about meteors in general, about radio observations of meteors, about the Brahms network, the Radio Meteor Zoo, and so on. And in this first video, I will briefly introduce you and give you some general information on meteors. First of all, I would like to introduce you to three terms that look very similar to each other, but actually refer to a different phenomena. These words are meteorite, meteor, and meteorite. So the, actually, sorry for my English, but the meteoroid is actually the correct pronunciation, is in general any interplanetary dust that orbits around the sun along different various orbits. And these particles have been orbiting around the sun for a very long time. And according to the IAU definition, it is any solid particles with a size that vary between 30 microns, which is really small, a tiny part of a millimeter, up to 1 meter in size. So this definition is relatively recent. I think it changed in 2016. So anything, any object with a size larger than 1 meter now is called an asteroid. This is just a definition, of course. As I mentioned, these particles orbit around the sun along very various orbits. And when they move relative to the Earth, they have a speed, relative speed, that can vary from approximately 11 kilometers per second to 72 kilometers per second. To give you an idea, 11 kilometers per second, something like 40,000 kilometers per hour. So this is extremely fast, much faster than the speed of a gun bullet, for example. And when these particles orbit around the sun, because they are relatively small or very small, they are influenced by the gravity of the planets, the giant planets mostly, but also they are influenced by the radiation pressure of the sun and so on. So their orbits slowly evolve with time, and sometimes they are on a collision orbit and they penetrate the Earth's atmosphere at very fast velocities. Then we have the phenomenon of the meteor. When these meteoroids enter at hypersonic velocities the Earth's atmosphere, in the upper atmosphere, so around altitude of, let's say, 100, 120 kilometers altitude, or a little bit below, they impact the atoms and the molecules of the upper atmosphere, and they burn. They heat up, and then they burn. And most of these tiny particles are completely burned at this altitude, around, let's say, 100 kilometer altitude, or as you can see on the slide, at altitudes between, let's say, 120 and 80 kilometers. Most of these tiny particles are fully vaporized, and they don't produce enough light to be detected from the ground, even using very sensitive and sophisticated cameras. But the bigger ones, let's say of the centimeter size, they can produce a visual phenomenon that can be detected from the ground using video cameras or simply with your eyes. And this visual phenomenon is called in general a meteor phenomenon, but more traditionally, let's say it's called a shooting star. And then the third term is called a meteorite, and that corresponds to bigger objects entering the Earth's atmosphere, so bigger meteoroids. These bigger objects, they are also heated up, burnt, vaporized, but a part of them can survive the passing to the atmosphere. And they are extremely slowed down compared to their initial velocities, as it is illustrated here on the slide. And at some point, they just, you know, the remnant that is not fully vaporized can fall to the ground in free fall. And therefore, the remnant that you can eventually and luckily in some cases find on the ground is actually called a meteorite. And these are very important objects because there are quite of testimonies of the early solar system conditions. Maybe these particles have been orbiting for a very long time, maybe not since the beginning, of course, of the solar system, but they were initially linked to some asteroids, for example, that were formed in the initial stages of the solar system. And therefore, finding these objects on the ground is extremely important and is the topic of several projects around the world, and in particular, one that will be mentioned in one of the next videos. Among the meteors, so the visual phenomenon, there are some objects which are extremely bright. The shooting stars, if you are not lucky to just look at in the correct direction, you will simply not notice them. But some of them are so bright and last for a few seconds, then your eyes will definitely be caught and you will not miss them if it happens somewhere in your visual phenomenon. Sight. These much brighter objects are called fireballs. And here on this picture, you have probably the most extreme case that was observed in the, let's say, modern era. It happened in 2013 in February above the city of Chelyabinsk in Russia. And what you can see here is really the final part of this object penetrating into the atmosphere with resulted in a big explosion. This object was estimated with a diameter size of something like 19 meters. So it was really, really an extreme case. And it went deep into the atmosphere and eventually exploded, as seen here, at an altitude of around 20-25 kilometers. So really deep on the ground. This explosion was estimated to several megatons. So it was really, it released a lot of energy and was, it could have had the potential of destroying completely the city if it had reached the ground. But fortunately it did not, but this explosion produced a shockwave that propagated to the ground and caused a series of damages in the city of Chelyabinsk. As you can see here, it was mostly windows that were blasted by the shockwave. And it was estimated that more than 7,000 buildings were damaged. And something like 1,500 injuries, mostly not severe injuries, of course, mostly people injured by broken windows. But this gives you an idea about the different types of objects and the terminology that is used. So meteor for the visual phenomenon, meteorite if we find a remnant on the ground, and fireballs for the extremely bright objects. Typically, this corresponds to objects that are, let's say, of the meter size, and therefore, according to the current definition, would really small asteroids. So this will end up the first video, and we will continue next with the difference between meteor showers and sporadic background. Thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, you can use the forum, and we will answer the questions there, or sometimes maybe making another of these videos. Thank you for your continuing support.